at you. I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning, and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that. I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning, and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that.
Eat them up.
It's just a little hit for the summer. Big deal. Whoa, here I go. I'm jumping out of green balloon. Geronimo, man, I like big wheels. 24, and I let the paint drip like the hose. Whoa, big car. Suicide goes like God's score.
Kentucky, just to our right, we welcome you into Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati, Ohio. This crowd loves their orange and black. The scene just a short time ago, they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football as the Bengals get set to do battle with the Jacksonville Jaguars. Again, everyone, I'm Brandon Gordon. To my left, Charles Davis. And Charles, you focus on this Bengal team entering play. The losers their last time out, so they'll look to make amends here.
And one of the best ways you can do that is to be at home, and they are. They're going to try and ride that home crowd and that wave of emotion to a victory in this one.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Jaguars, they come in feeling good after back-to-back victories. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
And going back through the tape, I thought they looked pretty good last week. It was a solid win, a comprehensive win.
Here come the Bengals now to take over. Leading him out, the rookie from Ohio State at 22 years of age, it's Justin Fields.
And he's playing at a very high level here in this early part of the season. In fact, he leads the NFL in passing yards. Now, that's not always an indicator of success, but in his case, it is.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before. and right at a yard. Now the Georgia Southern man. This is Jerick McKinnon. And he's got a Bengals first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Fields. Flush to his right. This is caught. It's Boyd. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. So a pretty early first quarter roughing the passer penalty.
Seems like the officials are going to let everyone know they're taking charge of this game. They're always going to protect the quarterback.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. A timeout here as we got a player shaken up, and that's Johnson who's down on the field. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. He takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of 3. And, Charles, we get a look here at the key inactives, and I tell you what, a big list for being this early in the season.
If there's any silver lining at all, you're hoping you can get these guys back, and now you'll play well down the stretch with them. But what you're also hoping is that the guys who have to play for them, the next man up mentality kicks in, and those guys take care of business.
Butker's kick here is good. And the Bengals are on the board first here. It's 3-0. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
And no return here for Agnew, so they'll bring it out, start the drive at the 25. For the first time, the Jacksonville Jaguars set to go here on offense, led out by the new face of the franchise, the number one overall pick, of course, from this year's draft. It's Trevor Lawrence out of Clemson.
And you and I both know that any win is a good win, and that's what they did last week. But there's also plenty for him to work on in his game, wasn't there?
Yeah.
Two touchdowns, an interception. Yeah, you know, he wants to increase that a little bit in terms of ratio. But first and foremost, they did win the game.
The numbers in last week's ball game for Robinson. 15 carries, 83 yards, and a touchdown.
And now that he's playing a Thursday night game, short week, you know he spent a lot of time in the trainer's room in the cold tub trying to get his legs back for this game.
There's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one a pickup of 15 for Jacksonville. First and 10, it's Lawrence. Completing it here to Marvin Jones. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. A play fake for Robinson. Now Lawrence. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. DJ Chark, the intended target, and it's third and short. Looking to throw, Lawrence. And connecting here with DJ Chark. And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Instead of a third and one run, they go pass and they get 12 yards out of it. It's a throw again as Lawrence. There's Manhurts, the tight end. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. First down, it's Robinson, and he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down. Now Lawrence to throw. He's going to drop this underneath for Robinson, and they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 10 yards there, good enough for a Jags first down. Lawrence with the handoff to Robinson. And The second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
How about the job there on the outside? Shed the wide receiver and was able to make the tackle on the perimeter.
Three-nothing after one on EA Sports. On second and 11 now. Lawrence, that's caught by Hollister. Showed off the toughness, but still corralled shy of the five at the six. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Lawrence will throw. Back of the end zone, could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete. And that'll bring up fourth down as his Cincy defense stands up on third. They'll run for it with Robinson. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. There wasn't even thought of a short field goal. There was no hesitation. They were going for it.
I think he was thinking ahead a couple plays ago that if he got in this situation, they were definitely going for it. And you're right. It was a confident call and a decisive run to pick it up.
And this ball incomplete. Looked very much to be a catchable ball and could not hang on. Second down coming up. Robinson fighting, but he won't get too far. Maybe a yard. That's all. Down to the two. The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of one there. Hyde is in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
Point after by Lambeau, up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. Taken at the goal line. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And they come into this one off the loss over the weekend, but you say if you're going to play a Thursday night game, this is the week to do it.
It certainly is, because you get right back out there, you don't have time to dwell on things. And look, your game plan is going to be a little more limited, but so is theirs. So that's when you just appeal to your top players. Guys, you make plays in this one, we out-execute them, we can walk away with a win.
And the Jags have five in the secondary here on third down. They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields sliding out of the pocket. He's airing it out for Williams. Thrown across his body and it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And what a return as he brings this one all the way back to the 25-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
To throw once more on second and 10. Lawrence. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. 18 yards on his first catch of the game. It's a first down. Lawrence. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. Jacob Hollister, the one he was looking for. But it'll be second and goal. They'll run here with Robinson. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. A nice run there as he picks up six. It's going to be third and goal now. Robinson again. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. 2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. And a loss of three to bring up four. The kick by Lambeau is good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So the turnover leads to points as they add three there.
Yeah, what a sequence there, and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The Bengals drive about to get going. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And here's a throw taken in by Boyd. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Now a first down throw, Fields. That's complete to Williams out of the backfield. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. From the gun, they will run with McKinnon. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. They'll look to pick it up with McKinnon. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Escaping the pressure right. And here is a leaping catch. He pulled it in. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Now they'll run. Murray. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. One man in the backfield, Murray, on second and goal. They'll give it to him up the middle, and he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Latavius Murray, as the first half is winding down, and the Bengals have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. Extra point by Butker is on target, and we are tied here in the second quarter. All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they'll take over with just 16 ticks remaining before intermission. Terrific running there to start the drive as that's going to go for 15 and a quick first down as well. Now a timeout called for by the offense as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Throwing now, Lawrence on first down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Looking to throw again on second down. Lawrence. And he's got his man on the out route. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. Final play of the half. It's Lawrence. He'll let this go for the end zone. And it's knocked away and incomplete. So thanks to the late touch. All right, folks, eager to get back to this week 4 matchup. We won't put up a fight. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And they'll bring it out to the 25 as Agnew elects for the touchback. Out come the Jaguars now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so We don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
They'll contain him to just four. Second down. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. On third down, it's Robinson. And this will be a Jaguars first down as he's got this up to the 40-yard line.
Every time I see James Robinson make a run as we just saw there, one word comes to mind for me, and that's determined. Undrafted, out of Illinois State, always doubted, and all he did, finished sixth in the NFL in rushing. What a find he was in 2020, and he expects that to continue in 2021.
25 yards that time. On the run, it's Robinson. Now Robinson coughs up the football. It's loose. But it looked like a Jaguar was able to cover this thing, and so Jacksonville will keep control. The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. They'll run it down with Robinson. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. The 25-yard line is what they need here. This is third down. Now Lawrence. And this is going to be incomplete. That'll bring up fourth down as his Cincy defense stands up on third. Lambeau will put this one through, and they will take the lead at 13-10. Well, they don't get a touchdown here on the opening drive of the third quarter, but I think maybe you still say mission accomplished as they come away with the lead.
No, absolutely. You keep the pressure on, right? You go downfield, get some points up on the board, and hope that you motivated your defense to take the field and hold that lead.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And they find themselves down on the scoreboard following the field goal a moment ago.
And I think even though they trail in the game now, I would consider that a win for their defense. And that's probably what they're telling the offense when they get to the bench. Hey, the onus is on you guys now. Get back out there and get us the lead back.
Another run for Murray on second down. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. It's a Bengal first down, a pickup of 11. Now a give. This is Murray. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Play action. It's Fields. Rolling to his right. And this is caught by Williams. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. So Jacksonville territory now. Here's a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Oh, a leap, and he will make the catch. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A good pickup there, 26 yards. On first down now, run with McKinnon. He'll get it inside the red zone, but only for a couple down to the 19. 8 yards to go on second down. Fields now to throw. Eluding the pressure right. That is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Bengals. Jerick McKinnon. His second touchdown on the season. And the Bengals are going to jump back in front. Well, I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, but his top two options were not available on that throw, so he went the safe route. Worked out pretty well.
It was like you were in the pocket. How about you going through the progressions like that? What a lot of offenses say, touchdown to check down.
Look downfield first, bring it back to the line of scrimmage. Not easy for a rookie to do. Oftentimes they get one look and they make their decision off of that. He went through three. That was impressive.
Jacksonville back on offense and ready to take over. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven past the 30 to the 32. One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Throwing again on second down, Lawrence looking for a slot man, and he's got him.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. This is caught inside the 15. And they're going to have this way down in Cincinnati territory. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive...
And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about.
Holding offense.
Late game, that hurts. Take the touchdown off the board.
No doubt about it, and this is where you make a great movie scene, right? Go in, rally the team. Okay, we lost points there. Let's get it back and go out and score again. Can he get it done?
That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked.
Got his man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. Chris Manhertz, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jaguars have retaken the lead. Those are the types of plays in these moments they were hoping for from this young rookie, able to put him up here in the field. And he's going to be taken down. It's a sack, and they fail on the try for two. Now whistles, and we've got a man down. A man down here following the kickoff. We'll check on his status when we get back. This taken in at the goal line. And able to get this out to the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Kalavon Chason just would not be denied. That's a loss of seven. Smith catches left side. And they're going to get him down well short of the first, as he can only get this to the 30. They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. And the Jags grab it. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. He let one slip away last week as well, so now two fumbles lost in as many weeks.
Well, we were out at practice, and we watched him work. And what did his quarterback coach talk about all week?
Being a two-hand monster.
And we looked at each other. Two-hand. Oh, I get it. Two-hand monster. Both hands on the football, taking care of it, putting it away so the ball doesn't get dropped.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more plus the 2-minute warning. And we'll be back. He'll try again. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. The kick by Lambeau is good, and that'll move their lead up to four now. So they get the three, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now, because they'd feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down. The Cincy offense about... drive. And that last turnover could have proven more costly, but their defense only gave up three. But now answering with a field goal doesn't do them much on this drive. They need to try and find the end zone. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of six. From the 30 on second down, Fields. And that nearly intercepted. It's incomplete. Now remember, he had a pick earlier, but couldn't reel that one in. From the gun on third down, Fields. Flushed out right. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Ooh, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
Now a throw here to his running back. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. He's back to throw. Flush to his right. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And still a little bit of time left, but the defense can't stop the clock. So three kneel downs should be enough to finish this one off. And able to find a little space. He gets this up over the 15 to the 16. 45 yards rushing for him now to this point. So they come up on second down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. They'll run again here with Robinson. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play. So now third down coming up. Lawrence. That caught by Manhurts. And they will get the conversion on third down, but the clock, a more pressing factor. It's a gain of seven, and that should just about do it. So this will be a win for Jacksonville, and they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger and dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through, and they close.
Religion was the moon, made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a toy, called a homeschooler. Never did homework, I was gone home with the work, no
to them. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling. Trying to make a killer, stack a couple million to the ceiling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. That's just how I'm feeling.
No more feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling.
Never make right. Me and they are suffering life, them I get by. Never bow for the fame, no. Heads high. Never come here, so all them I see a tear light. Been a real from the ghetto. I ain't never gonna switch, that's facts though. Can't get me out like stain. Come a grow tough, I'ma know pain. Haters talk with a bad tongue. Can't break me, twiddle be so dumb. I'ma be a giant T5-0 from doing it so big like Drake, I'm on one. My big boss got me feeling so bossy like Lauren Hill. Me, I kill them softly. This a girl rather fi be called a naughty. Cause if my two liar, then it's gonna cost me. And
that's just how I feel.
Yeah.
That's just how I'm feeling.
That's how I feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. Big boss, I'm a big boss. Up north, Rick Ross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Bet against me, that's a big love. You about to find out what the hell. I find then I get low. Lift off, it ain't nothing to cut the off. Stop frying, don't let it get soft. Covered in yolk, in yolk. Wonder why I got the whole world pissed off. That's how I'm feeling. That's just how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
Today, from Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara, California, it's week four of the NFL on EA Sports.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
So here's the first drive now for the 49ers.
They're led out by the NFL's MVP from 2019, now in his fourth season out of Louisville, Lamar Jackson.
And he ought to have a lot of pep in his step after last week's performance, because he did exactly as you want him to play if you're a coach. Three touchdown passes, zero interceptions, which usually means you're making a lot of right decisions out there.
And got him to win. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down. Now Jackson. And Jackson cannot get away, and he'll go down.
Carlos Dunlap, the Florida Gator, chopping his way to the quarterback.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 9.
From the gun, it's Jackson, escaping the pressure right.
Man open, that's Deebo Samuel. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
To throw is Jackson, eluding the pressure right.
And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. Well, you know, paramount for this defense is trying to keep Lamar Jackson somewhat contained when he tries to run. They did a pretty good job of it there.
And you know what's so difficult for every defense that has to prepare for Lamar Jackson? You have to think and play at the same time. And I know that sounds like something you're supposed to do, but when you have to think about your assignments against him, it often slows down your feet. You don't move as fast. You've got to be prepared for this guy every step of the way and then try and match his athleticism.
And this is dropped. Oh, boy. a chance for a big play early, but he could not secure it.
And Charles, despite this list of key inactives that we see here, they've obviously still been pretty successful.
Give everyone credit for this one, because to me, when that happens, key guys are out, the next man steps up and plays well, but that starts with the organization itself, all the way through. No excuses for guys being out. Finding guys who are capable backups who can step up and play when they need them, and we've seen the results of that. This team knows how to work through things.
And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first. It'll be a gain of four, but it won't be enough. It leaves him with a fourth down now.
Well, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted.
Picked off by Jamal Adams, and he'll take it all the way up near the 30-yard line.
Seattle's offense ready to go here for the first time, and leading them is the seven-time Pro Bowler in his 10th year now. The NFL, Russell Wilson.
I loved his quote during the week. If I were a defensive back, I would have wanted to play against me last week as well. He's trying to eliminate those turnovers, those interceptions, and get back on the positive side of the ledger throwing touchdown passes.
Yeah, had four of those picks, led to the loss. The numbers on the ground for Carson last week. 16 carries, 71 yards.
And give him a ton of credit. He's running the ball really well. But I look at those guys up front. That unit is truly playing as just that. Every move that they make, their teammate understands what that move means and what they need to do. And right now, they're starting to grind it out pretty well.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Wilson to Metcalf that time. First down, Seattle. Here's Wilson. That completes it again to Metcalf. And he's brought down. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Now it's Wilson. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. The linebacker, Fred Warner, right there on the coverage. Now this rivalry, Charles, the Seahawks and Niners, really one of the best in the NFL. So many great games in the last decade or so between these two. Where does this one rank for you in terms of best rivalries of, you know, let's say, the 21st century?
I'm so glad you phrased it that way, because we look back on some of the best rivalries in the NFL. We're talking about traditional rivalries like Bears-Packers. But here in the 21st century, it's hard to beat Seahawks and Niners, because when they get together, you're often playing for division titles, positioning in the playoffs, and chasing the Super Bowl. Similar to Ravens and Steelers, two of the best rivalries in the NFL.
That's complete to Disley, the tight end. Now a loose football, the ball comes out, and now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. Well, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back, and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your playmakers and give them the football.
On second down at four, Jackson forced out to his left. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first. Here's Edwards-Helaire. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Going deep for Diggs. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in. After the incompletion, here now, 3rd and 2. Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Now we've got whistles and a timeout here. Yeah, it looks like we've got a 49er that's down on the field. They go play action with Jackson. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. And the open receiver, it's Robert Woods. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. On first down, they'll run with Hunt. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll be out of bounds. 41 yards rushing for him now in his first 2 carries of the ball game.
Sometimes those lines that are drawn on a grease board or in a playbook, they come to life out on the field, don't they? And we just saw that in that outside handoff to the right.
That right tackle, he gets excited for that call, doesn't he?
He does, because he just wants to dominate his guy and say, listen, I was the point of attack. I took care of business. That's why you're able to get downfield and add all those yards to your total.
Yeah, really nice gain there. On second and goal, the lone man in the backfield is Hunt. Here's Jackson. And it's complete in the end zone. Touchdown, 49ers. Stephon Diggs, his 3rd touchdown now on the year, as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game.
as Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. And this will come out to the 25 as Reed opts for the touchback. Seattle's offense coming back onto the field, ready for their second drive. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they thought they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing? Not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? And this will be a Seahawks first down as he's able to get this up to the 37-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain and good enough to move the chains. Now Wilson on first down. That one taken in by Dwayne Eskridge. Good for 8 yards to the 45. Ahead of the chains now, second and two. Here's Carson. He'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46. Now we're going to get a timeout here as it looks like there's a Seahawk injured on the play. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Wilson now to throw on third down. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down, and he'll have it by plenty as they're able to keep the drive alive on third and inches. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Now left side, a completion to his tight end. There he goes inside the 30. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
Wilson will throw again. And this will go to Carson out wide. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. From the gun, it's Wilson. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. 3 yards the gain there, second down. To throw is Wilson. And that one finds the ground, breaking a string of 5 straight completions. And it brings up second down. No, third down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. And he's got his man in stride, complete. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Again, Wilson. And he finds Lockett in the end zone. Touchdown, Seattle. Tyler Lockett, his first touchdown on the year. And the Seahawks are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point up and through by Myers. And we are tied here in the second quarter. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Set to return. Here's Raheem Mostert. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Well, the Niners going back on offense now late in this first half. And with a little under a minute to play, they may be looking to pick up some yardage here, maybe try and come up with a field goal to seize the lead before intermission. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark it down at the 49. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. Now Jackson on first down. And Jackson cannot get away, and he'll go down. Darrell Taylor, credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of 6.
It's caught by Hooper. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And he hauls it in the end zone. Touchdown, San Francisco. Stephon Diggs. As the first half is winding down, and the 49ers have now taken the lead. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that makes the score 14-7. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense, as they'll take over with just 13 seconds to go before the break. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. They follow up the gain of two with a gain of one that time. All right, folks, eager to get back to this week four matchup. We won't put up a fight. The Seahawks trailing, but they will have possession first here as we resume action in the third quarter. No run back here for Reed, so this will come out to the 25. The Bucs ready to go here to begin the third quarter. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
Well, paraphrasing the gold medal hockey-winning coach Herb Brooks, I just say you continue.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And the return will stop right around the 25. But that one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Sidney Jones. And the return just out across the 15 to the 16-yard line. He got outside the pocket there trying to improvise, and he was calling for the ball downfield, but still the interception.
I think what happened, he did call for the ball thinking that he was open, but I think the quarterback spotted him too late. And that margin that he had on the defenders, that got eaten up, and they came up with the interception.
After the interception, here's Wilson. And this a quick slant to Lockett. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. This is Carson. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. He'll find Metcalf. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. On second down, it's Carson. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
The Seahawks moving pretty well through the air. Another first down. Now it's Carson, able to push forward for about 4 down to the 37.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls. Are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. The Seahawks moving pretty well through the air. Another first down. Wilson. He's got his man. This is Tate. A gain of 6 there on first. Second down at 4.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. On the delay, here's Carson. A beautiful fake. And boy, the strength on display there as he rumbles through tacklers for a gain of about 8. On second and a couple. Wilson, touchdown, Seahawks. Gerald Everett, his first touchdown on the year. And the Seahawks are an extra point away from tying this ball game here in the final moments of the third quarter. Myers connects on the PAT, and they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Lamar Jackson marching back onto the field. And it was his interception on the last drive that wound up leading to a game-tying touchdown.
And somehow, you can make this a positive, though. You know why? Game tied now. So you're not protecting a lead. So you're not playing that way. You've got to go get the lead again. So maybe it loosens him up a little bit and allows him to go ahead and be a little more free in his play.
From the 27, Jackson flushed out right. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That his first catch so far. They've held him under wraps, but he's got a first down there. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. They'll run with Hunt. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43. The Niners on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. Time to his left. And I think the ball's out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. You can almost see inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. Well, they deemed it 4-down territory, and they got 4 yards to pick up the first. Jackson now. They'll roll him out right. And Diggs has it. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. That now 2 completions for him on this drive, and these aren't ordinary completions, they're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way, oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got him? Someone cover him. That type of indecision.
And across the goal line, into the end zone, touchdown 49ers. Clyde Edwards-Helaire, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the 49ers answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead
here in the fourth.
Gonzalez good on the extra point, and the lead is now 21-14.
Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown.
This is DJ Reed returning.
And he won't quite make it to the 25.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
And now after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give them a first down. Now Wilson. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
It's a gain of 12. First down Seahawks.
Throwing is Wilson. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. The linebacker, Fred Warner, right there on the coverage.
Second and 10.
They go play action now. Wilson. Looking left sideline. Incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf. And it's third down.
An important play right here. Third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
It's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Here we go. It's Wilson on fourth down, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. A defensive breakdown allows a pickup of 16 on fourth down.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Throwing again here, Wilson.
A pass underneath for Carson.
And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup. There's Wilson. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Now Wilson. Flush to his right. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movements. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to do what we call flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
46 yards on the ground for him so far.
And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up. Throwing now is Wilson, and it's caught. It's a touchdown. So they rally here in the final minute, and they're an extra point away from tying this game.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. He finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And, partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away.
Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone.
And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play. But if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5.
Here's Jackson.
Juke. The ball comes out, and the Seahawks have picked it up.
review the play. The run on the field is reversed.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. He'll buy some time right. This is caught. It's Woods. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. Like he's going to throw it, and it's complete. They're going to get the first. The fake field goal catches everyone by surprise, and the Niners on one play have taken the lead.
For a big tight end, he can sure move like a slot receiver when he gets ahead of steam going, and as a defensive back, you've got a big decision to make when he's moving like that.
So the victory here for San Francisco, and it wasn't really always pretty. They had their bumps and bruises, really both sides did, but they did what they needed to do at home to get the win.
Yeah, they really had to grind this one out, didn't they? Because nothing came easy.
turn it into a win. I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
A gain of six there on first. To throw again on second down. Brady, there's Evans again, complete. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
From the 30 on second down, Brady. This one complete to Scott Miller. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 19. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Now a first down carry by Jones. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Now look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched it more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
Trying to defend the out route there, got the PI call.
And you know what's difficult about that one? Is sometimes you want to make the undercut move and go for the football, and other times you just want to hang on the upfield shoulder and make the tackle. I think he got caught in between and created a foul.
Brady now to throw. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. A 2-yard touchdown grab, and the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead.
I do believe we came here to see a game, didn't we? And it looks like he's running what we call routes versus air. You just go out there with your offensive unit and throw the football with no defense. He's 5 for 5 on the opening drive.
He was on his game there for drive number one, but the only thing is now he can't go any higher than that. He was so perfect. Can he do it again later?
Yeah, all he cares about right now is making it 10 for 10, 15 for 15.
Keeping that going.
And he feels like he can get it done.
So here come the Patriots to take over on offense. They'll be led out by their 24-year-old quarterback in his fourth season from USC, a former third overall pick, Sam Darnold.
And I think it's safe to say that, and I heard him say it in the post-game press conference, that was a team win last week because he didn't really play up to his normal standards, throwing 2 interceptions.
No touchdown.
Yeah, didn't offset it at all, but the team found a way to get it done.
Escaping the pressure right. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That one goes for 24 yards, eluding the pressure right. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete. He was looking for Tyree. Kill that time, and that'll bring up second down. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. He'll get about 4 here, down to the 43-yard line.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Throwing here on third down, Darnold. He'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey. And he's going to get this inside the 30. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. On first down, this is McCaffrey. Down right around the 25. The numbers for McCaffrey last week. 15 carries, 65 yards, and a touchdown as well.
He's been a huge part of their winning streak because he establishes not just an identity and a tone, but the team relies on it. He takes care of the football, he gains yardage for him, chews up clock, and that's been a big part of why they're winning games lately.
And they'll get this down to the 10. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. Back to throw, Darnold. Open man is Hill. He's got it. That catch good for only a couple. Ball at the 9 on 2nd and 8. Back to the ground attack here. It's McCaffrey. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Christian McCaffrey, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know it sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front, offensive line, collective victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. These two teams all tied after one. Going for Howard, but the pass intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. Good starting field position for them as they come up 1st and 10 at their own 43. After the interception, here's Darnold. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Oh, now Miller slow in getting up. He's still down on the ground. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. 2nd and 19. We'll get a report when we return to Foxborough. And Hill with it over the middle. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on 3rd. A fake to McCaffrey. Now Darnold. And that is incomplete. But the pressure there on 3rd down, forcing the errant pass. 4th down coming up.
Coverage was awfully tight there on 3rd down. They actually closed off all the passing lanes, forcing the incompletion and bringing up 4th down.
Here we go with McCaffrey. Sheds him off at the 45. And he will have a 1st down here at about the 40. Give them credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on 4th. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. On 1st down, Darnold. His throw incomplete. Unable to get it to Gronkowski that time. That'll bring up 2nd down. And now the 1st throw for the backup quarterback. That one complete to Hill. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. That one good for 20 on the catch and run. That's the number 2 receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number 2 for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number 1.
They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down. Throwing again is Darnold. Touchdown, Patriots. Keenan Allen. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Patriots have taken the lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. So that drive in total 8 plays. And it's finished off by a Pats touchdown. This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Bring it up. The Bucks offense set to begin their next possession.
And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
They'll run on first down. Jones. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Brady gives this one off to Jones. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. It'll go down as a two-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. From the gun, it's Brady. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Jonathan Jones. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
Yeah, that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down. Now a throw here to his running back. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. We've hit the two-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. And that's complete to the right side. It's Allen. And he's taken down inside the 30. Give him 15 yards on that one, and New England has a first down. Play action. It's Darnold. Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And a good return here as he takes it up past the 30-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Oh, a leap, and he will make the catch. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Shotgun now for Brady. Looking for Godwin again, and he's got him once more. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Here's Brady. And that is caught. What a catch inside the five. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. On second and goal, Brady looking for Brown, and he's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Antonio Brown, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Bucs are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point put through by Succop, and we are tied here in the second quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Patriots with the football here late in this first half as they will take over here with a little more than 30 seconds remaining. Gets this one to Hill. He's at the 30. 10.
Let's get that.
And walk the way in. Touchdown, New England. Tyreek Hill, 76 yards. And the Patriots are able to strike quickly for six. Well, that's a heck of a response to regain the lead after we had seen the touchdown to tie the game.
I would say what we just saw there was a great amount of poise, because typically when teams tie the game up, it's a little bit of a, how would you say, you kind of take a step back and have to get yourself regrouped.
They regrouped in a hurry, didn't they? They attacked back after they'd been tied.
And in a big way, that was a statement long touchdown. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go. Brady now on first down. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And he's giving his guys a shot for late points as they will take over in range for a field goal. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now it's Darnold. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. They'll fake the handoff. Now Darnold. He finds his target, Allen. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. I know it's an emotional game, Charles. You can't do that.
And when you get into your film sessions and you argue your case with your coaches, that's exactly what they say at the end. You just can't do it. It costs your team.
Got a man right side. It's McCaffrey. Touchdown. Christian McCaffrey as time expires in the first half. And the Patriots would extend their lead here just before halftime.
Well, my education continues in this game. I've got to tell you, because there's not an analyst in the world that would have said pass up the field goal here, go for it, and expect for it to be successful. And it.
All right, folks, eager to get back to this week four matchup. We won't put up a fight. So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. Tyreek Hill making his way back out towards the huddle. And they've got to figure out how to stop some of the highlights that we're seeing on the screen here.
And what it feels like, he's going to say, it doesn't matter what you put out here. I am having a big-time performance. I'm playing at a big-time level. Just keep throwing me the football.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
42 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Darnold will hand off to McCaffrey. Stays on his feet, and he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. He continues to deliver a first down here. He had 4 catches in the first half, and this one number 5. Darnold down to throw. And going deep for Hill. And this is caught. Touchdown, Patriots. Tyreek Hill with his 2nd TD of the game, his 6th on the year. And the Patriots, they add on to their lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Taken at the goal line. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Here comes the Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the second half. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down. Throwing is Brady on third down. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. It's Kyler Duggar who picks it. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. So here are the Patriots to take over. They're on a three-game winning streak, and right now looking good in this one as well. And he'll be pulled down as a penalty flag will rein in as well, and that would appear to be a face mask. So give him the yardage on the completion and also tack on 15 more.
If you get that hand up there, you've got to let go immediately or just not close the hand at all. He did, gave it a tug, and that was easy for the officials to see.
Oh, nice move. And he's brought down. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. McCaffrey is into the end zone. Touchdown, New England.
Well, three scores in this game, I think that deserves some type of a broad gesture. I know in hockey, that's called a hat trick and people throw their hats out on the ice. What about us? What can we do for this guy?
Well, if I'm his teammates, I'm buying him a little steak dinner tonight, right? At least a skirt steak, probably a filet.
Oh, you're going big. I like that.
Yeah, I mean, skirt at
minimum.
I mean,
skirt steak, come on. You can't give the guy a skirt steak his first three times.
Filet, 16 ounce.
Porterhouse.
Fine. This taking in at the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. A throw and a quick slant going to be complete. Oh, that's just not fair. And now room to run. And in for the Buccaneers touchdown. Mike Evans, his first touchdown on the year. And the Bucs are able to cut into that deficit. Well, if they're going to make a game of this in the second half, they need a few big plays to go their way. That's one.
And the way to get it done is to also conserve time. So to your point, that big play right there, now you're not moving the ball downfield, taking time off the clock. You're leaving yourself a better avenue to continue to try and make a comeback.
And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. They've really distanced themselves. They have put the pedal to the metal, I guess, so to speak.
So definitely have them in the rearview mirror, don't they? I mean, you're exactly right. Being able to string together these drives that end up in points, it's almost like a run in basketball to create that distance, and they're in a really big-time one right now.
It becomes contagious, doesn't it?
It absolutely does, because oftentimes it translates to your defense as well, because they're excited about getting the ball back for their offense that's playing so well.
Well, they are clicking right now. Flushed out right. He is going to find Hill here. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And it's picked up by the Buccaneers. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. Oh, he tried to pitch it, and the ball's loose. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble. So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Here's Darnold. And he'll only get this to about the 35. Well short of the line to gain. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down. They'll run for it. McCaffrey. And this doesn't end well at all as they stop him far behind the line to gain. The Patriots come up empty on fourth down. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. From Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10 at the 34. To throw, it's Brady. That's caught by Howard. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Looking to throw again on second down. Brady.
Nowadays, quarterbacks don't mind throwing into coverage because of the confidence they have in their receivers to come down with the ball. But sometimes you have to be careful you don't get too confident and throw an interception.
Brady's throw on third down there is incomplete. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. They'll go with a big back Fournette. And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Throwing on first down is Brady. This one swung out here to Jones. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. It'll be a gain of 6, and it'll be a second down. From midfield, here's Brady. And his throw's going to be incomplete. The tight end Cameron Brait was the target, and it's third down. From the gun, it's Brady. And Brady, the tight end's got it. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. Brady now on first down. Open man is Howard, the tight end. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Now Brady again. That is caught. It's Chris Godwin. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots' 12-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. To throw is Brady. Drops it to Jones in the flat. And this carry brought to an end at the 8. Good stick skills, just not much room there to operate. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Brady. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. Here's Brady to throw. Godwin's got it. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Chris Godwin. His second touchdown on the season. And the Bucs have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still 2 scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you'd kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
And this is secured by the Patriots. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop, 1:50 left in the football game. This, in all probability, another run here on 2nd and 8. They'll give it up to McCaffrey. The Bucs forced to use their 3rd and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16. 99 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. And they'll get him down right around the 16. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. A handoff left, McCaffrey. He will push his way down to about the 14. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Now a give, right side McCaffrey. And they're going to drop him well shy of the first as he can only make it to the 11. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up the 4th down. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. 10 yards is the pickup there, and that should just about put a bow on this one. On the ground, McCaffrey. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's 2nd down. Now another timeout called for by the offense. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, 2nd and goal. And Darnold wants to throw the football. And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. Tyreek Hill there to make the grab. And the Patriots are about to make it 4 straight as they add to this 4th quarter advantage. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. And he'll get this up past the 45. It's a 1st down, but the tackle comes in bounds. A big offensive explosion help leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Patriots, that early momentum continues here as they move to 4-0. And they'll hit the road next week to...
will go. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me, did you come through as pure gold?
You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. Listen, you don't want no trouble, cuz. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red Dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out.
Today, from Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati, it's week 5 of the NFL on EA Sports.
This fielded right at the goal line. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here come the Bengals now to take over. Leading him out, the rookie from Ohio State at 22 years of age, it's Justin Fields.
And he's been playing at an elite level. Here in this early half of the season, tops in the league in touchdown passes at this point. This is definitely a wide open offense, and we'll see if he can keep his string of good games going right here.
And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Fields. A dump down to McKinnon. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. It's a gain of 13, and the Bengals have a first down. Here's Fields. Flush to it, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. They could not contain Kenny Clark as he gets home for the sack. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's 2nd and 15. Now the Georgia Southern man. This is Jerick McKinnon. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. They'll wind up getting 10 back there as it'll leave him with a 3rd and 5. To throw his Fields. Escaping the pressure right. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th. They snap it to Fields. And this is caught. He hits Moore. Touchdown, Bengals. DJ Moore with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score.
And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible? Or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Now we get a look at Aaron Rodgers as he gets set to lead this Green Bay Packer offense. Rodgers now in his 17th season in the league, and of course, coming off the MVP trophy.
I think Aaron Rodgers is one of the poster boys for persistence and belief in self. Because coming out of high school, he had 0 scholarship offers in the D1 level. Went to a junior college, went to Cal, and just blew up there. And then, of course, as a first-round draft pick, but a lot lower than what he expected in the first round. And then had to sit behind Brett Favre for a few years in Green Bay before getting his shot. Now he's probably one of the better quarterbacks that we've seen come down the pipe.
Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. It's a gain of 16 and a first down for the green and gold. Now it's Rodgers. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates. So a first interception thrown for him there, and that really not the best decision either.
Not at all, and that's something he did not do in their victory last week. No interceptions in that game, but this defense, they're able to take advantage of an early mistake. Now let's see if it got turned it into points.
One play action, Fields. Yeah, give him 4 yards there, it'll be second and six. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. His second catch, and this one not nearly as electrifying as his first. And it'll bring up third down now. They'll run here. It's Murray. Fields on first down. Eluding the pressure right. He finds Latavius Murray. Oh, he faked it with a juke. Now he's got some room. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Now Fields, 22 yards on the catch. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Dean Lowry. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of 6. To try again after the sack. Fields. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander, and he'll return it to the 24-yard line. So problems with errant passing continuing. Remember, he threw 2 picks in the loss last week, and now another here in this first quarter.
And sometimes, partner, this is the result of a quarterback who's simply trying to do too much. Feels like he's trying to make up for what he did last week, and you can't do it all on one throw.
And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. The catch and run, good for 24 yards. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Now on second and 13, Rodgers. And that's complete to Adams. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. To throw, it's Rodgers. Jones has it. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. Now Rodgers, a free play. And this one drops incomplete, but I think the defense jumped.
Offside, defense.
Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the 5 and keep it moving.
After the penalty, it's Jones. Jones breaking from the contact. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it'll keep the drive moving. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Trying to get it to Adams, but it's intercepted. Chidobe Awuzie with a pick. And he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. They were trying to go to Brown once again, and now it's second down. Fields now to throw. He's going to look deep for Moore. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play. but he could not pull it in. Throwing on third down, Fields.
And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down.
Dean Lowry picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
Flush to his right.
He'll get this to his tight end. It's Jonnu Smith.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Hey, nothing to see here. Just your standard fourth down gain of 28 yards. And the drive keeps going. So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 as they've got it to the 28-yard line. Now here's a throw that's complete. Brown with the stick skills. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays. Escaping the pressure right. And a quick shuffle pass here is complete. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. It'll be a gain of 9, and that'll make it second and short. Now a give. This is Murray. Fields on the sneak. And no signal, but I don't think he got the surge behind center. No, he's going to be kept out of the end zone. No gain there as he kept it. And he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. Justin Fields keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Bengals are able to grow their lead. So with second and goal, still had a couple of downs to work with. They tried the sneak, and they got in.
I like the idea that they did it early in the down and distance count. Second down as opposed to waiting later on. I think it fooled them a little bit, but how about the push they got up front to get the quarterback through?
Big push and a touchdown to boot.
And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway.
To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
47 yards rushing for him now on just his first three carries.
On first down, Rodgers.
He'll find his tight end here, DeGuara.
They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. 2 minutes to play. First half, it's 14-0. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 19. 11 yards there as they connect on the quick slant. Now a throw here to his running back. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Toward the pylon, caught! And it's a Packers touchdown. Marquez Valdez-Scantling, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Packers have cut it back within a score.
Obviously, Brandon, they couldn't get it all back with just one score, but that touchdown chips into the lead, and now it makes the comeback a little bit more manageable.
Extra point up and good by Crosby, and that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And not a good return here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. The Bengals drive about to get going. And still plenty of time remaining here in the half, more than a minute. And we'll see if they just want to protect that lead or try to add on to it.
Well, with as much time as is left on the clock, I would imagine it would be the latter. I think they're going to try and add on to it. So what they're going to tell the team is very simply, if you can get out of bounds after making a play downfield, terrific. If you can't, everyone hustle to the line of scrimmage, either run another play or clock it and start over again.
And he makes it all the way down to the 31. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Back to throw. Fields steps away to his left. Going for it all. And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. Jonnu Smith, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bengals, they widen their lead.
And that's certainly an important score right there because they gave themselves a two-score cushion heading towards halftime. Now you got to force the other team out of their comfort zone, and it changes the way you approach the second half as well. How you want to do things on offense, and your defense feels much better too, having that lead.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee, and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And we'll see how aggressive they want to be in these final stages before the half. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. This time, they'll just keep this on the ground. And he's going to have a first down, but not sure it'll matter as the clock will continue to run. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Throw over the middle, caught by DeGuara. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Throwing again on second down. Rodgers got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. From midfield, here's Rodgers. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off by Mike Hilton. And a potential turning point as he'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half. And that now two interceptions thrown in the second quarter.
And you know, a lot of people look at these guys and they think to themselves that maybe, possibly, they're still thinking about the first one. And they probably are. I think in this case, he's just trying to atone for the first interception.
And this is caught. Touchdown. Wait, hold a second here. Flag down. Let's see if this will stand. So retract the yardage and you want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it. The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action. Ready for the third quarter. And no run back here as the third quarter will commence with a touchback. Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Here's Rodgers to throw. It's caught here by Adams. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. It's Logan Wilson there to bring him down. Second down and eight. Throwing is Rodgers. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. So the screen good for only two. Now it's third down. From the gun, it's Rodgers. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Mike Hilton. The first half did not go their way, and that's not going to help matters at all. An interception here on the opening drive of the third quarter.
Obviously not what they were striving to accomplish, but you know who's really upset on their team? The defense. Already trailing, they're going to be counted on to try and hold that score at least where it is.
And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line, tackled there. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down, dancing to his left. This is Smith with a grab. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. That one goes for 36 yards. Murray. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. And this is going to be Packer football.
Pardon me, you know how often we hear about the...
And now, as with every potential turnover, we're going to take a second look at those two.
After viewing the play, the right of the field is reversed.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will... He's got it. Touchdown, Bengals. Mike Williams, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bengals use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. Extra point by Butker is on target. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. The touchdown. Here's Butker on to kick it away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time.
And now here is another interception. Picked off at about the 31. And he'll get this back down to about the 12-yard line. That is now 5 interceptions that he has thrown in this ball game. If I asked you to speculate what's possibly going on in his head, what would you say?
Well, if he's as mentally strong as I believe he is, he understands that not all these picks have been his fault. You know, some of the throws, yes, but there have been a good number of them where he hasn't been helped by his own receivers, and they've turned into interceptions. So he knows if he keeps firing, perhaps good things can happen, not just in this game, but especially in later ones.
Well, that'll be incomplete. He took a shot as he let that go, and it's going to bring up a third down. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Well, Za'Darius Smith there getting in and bringing him to the ground. On fourth down, Fields. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Chris Barnes. And he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. He'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 23. Not the start to the drive they were looking for. That run doesn't do much at all.
No, not at all, and it leaves them with 3rd and long. And, you know, this is the time of game where these drives really, really start to matter. They got to make some moves.
And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Offense.
So a decent game, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Now a deep ball here, hauled in just past the 50. Touchdown, Packers! Marquez Valdes-Scantling, an 80-yard touchdown. And the Packers make some inroads here on that deficit. He has his 2 scores, but still a sizable deficit in this game.
Do you have him in fantasy football this week?
Unfortunately, no.
It's too bad, right? That would have been big points. But he is really trying to rally his team as best he can. Things are not going as well the rest of the way for them. That's why they're down with this deficit. He might need to score a couple of more times to give them a chance.
And down he goes just shy of the 25. Now, penalty marker is down. Let's see what that's about. Set him up with not great field position.
Not at all when you tack on the penalty. But that field position after the return wasn't terrific. It's not a great starting field position as well.
And just not a ton of room to work with. He'll get it to the 15 for a gain of 2. Second and eight. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Eluding the pressure right. Complete. Smith has it. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try to put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Good job there of getting his tight end involved, because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a first down.
Give him nine there on the first down completion. Back now in Cincinnati. It's the Bengals in possession of the football and in possession of the lead as well as we start the fourth. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 2 yards, good enough for first. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first from the 32 now. Here's first and 10. Now it's Fields. He'll take a shot for the end zone. Well, this one almost intercepted. Had a chance to come down with it in the end zone, but could not hang on. On second and 10, Fields flushed out right. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. The improv act there, good for nine, and now they'll be looking at a third and short, third and one. A handoff, it's Murray. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. And here we go on fourth down, Fields. And he's going to have his running back, it's complete. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. That one good for 17 yards on fourth. Couldn't ask for much more from your offense there. First down. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Here's Fields. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Second down and goal. Fields rolling, and that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. Marquise Brown, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bengals look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point by Butker is on target. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
Rodgers now on first down. They find some open field here. Touchdown, Packers! Marquez Valdez-Scantling with touchdown number 3 in the game and 6 on the year. And the Packers have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. Well, they needed 3 scores to have any chance. There's the first of the 3 as they get into the end zone.
Yeah, Brandon, I think that our guys at Next Gen Stats in charge of the win probability are probably saying your chances still aren't great. But now, you still got more than 3 minutes to go. You got to focus on the task at hand, which is going to be getting the football back as quickly as possible.
And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that, just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics would tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't
you? All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Fields, we know he has the good mobility. He flashes it there as he scrambles for the first down. On first down, Murray. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. Play action. Fields gonna throw deep for the end zone, and it is incomplete. I had a defender running right with him, and now it's third down. From the gun on third down, Fields, and he's got his man, Marquise Brown, and he is gonna have a Bengals first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on third and five. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of. He's got it. Touchdown, Bengals. Mike Williams. His second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Bengals look like they're about to put an end to their 2-game losing streak as they add on to their lead. That's caught at the one. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by 2 more. And the formula there on the 2-point try, they go 5 wide, not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that if someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind you because they run out of space with the back line. But in this case, the offense figured it out.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now Rodgers. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Cobb. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He'll find Aguara complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They call his number again. It's his 6th catch and a first down. 5 yards on the pickup, and it's a second down. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Rodgers finding Adams for a Packer first. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. This one swung out here to Jones. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. A good-looking drive for the Packers so far. It's a first down. No gain there on the completion, second and 10. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up to throw again on second down. Rodgers, and he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 26. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. Rodgers now on first down. That ball is caught. Marquez Valdez-Scantling. Touchdown. Marquez Valdez-Scantling. 26 yards. And the Packers get a score closer.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team. But I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film. But this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
So time definitely not in their favor. Down 2 scores, but they'll try the onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds remaining. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. That one looks like he'll throw here. And he's got the hook up to Moore. Now the Packers going to burn their 3rd and final timeout as they stop it with 14 seconds to go in the game.
Third and two, Fields being chased out left. He wants it all for the end zone. And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. DJ Moore, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bengals have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. They'll try and run it here. Trying to bust out of that losing funk, and these fans have to like this. And all right, fellas, this is more like it.
And I know that if this holds up after the game, they're going to give the fans a lot of credit being at home, getting the support. But you and I both know it goes deeper than that. They had to get.
They run with McCaffrey off the option. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down. Now it's Darnold. They'll roll him out right. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a hole. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down. This is McCaffrey on the give. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. And they'll try the air now with Darnold. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Justin Reed. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Now the first carry here for Phillip Lindsay. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. A run with Lindsay out of the gun. And he'll get only a couple up to the 22. This defense for the Patriots, they were terrific a week ago in that victory over Tampa Bay, Charles.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away four times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? Do you try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guys open before you deliver?
On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. Back deep is Tyreek Hill. So a change of possession here on the punt, and the Patriots take over. Out comes Christian McCaffrey with the rest of the offense. Last week, over 100 yards, 3 touchdowns. We were talking with him on the field before the game. He said simply, I was in a groove. He obviously was.
And I think he's been a little modest about that, being in a groove. That's a big-time game right there. And I think he feels like his entire team is coming along with him, because they're creating spaces and holes for him to run through. He's making people miss, running through tackles. They are locked in a big way and confident about this game as well.
Looking for his home. Pro tight end Rob Gronkowski to throw on second and 10. Darnold over the middle. That's complete to McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That one good for 20 on the catch and run. He'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey. And he's got this down to the 35. Consecutive catches for him. That good for 11. Faking the give, Darnold. Flush to his right. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. There's Henry. Touchdown, Patriots. Hunter Henry. His first touchdown on the year. And the Pats have taken the early lead. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Oh,
remember
yeah.
What he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25. So now we get set to see Houston for their second drive of the ball game. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here too after a good stop. They'll run for the first time with Johnson. Able to push his way through. And some room to maneuver. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that, because now it doesn't go on the books. But now they have to make that up again, don't they?
It's a 4-yard pickup, and all of a sudden here, it's third down. A shotgun snap for Watson. Forced out to his left. And he's finally taken down, and it's a big game there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. One quarter down, 8-0 the score. On first and 10, Watson. Rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Patriot defense has a touchdown. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
I think we're sensing a trend here. Two first half touchdowns. After going for two after the first score, CD, I thought maybe they would kick the PAT here. No, they get two more.
No, they decided to really press the advantage, because remember, getting the two after the first score, you've already got the other team back on their heels if they're going to mount a comeback. But to go up two scores and two-point conversions, you've really got them thinking on the other sideline.
And here comes the Texans now. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play too.
Lindsey now off the read option. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Dante Hightower on the stop.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Now it's Watson. Throw right side into the hands of Akins. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and nine looming. Here's Watson. That's complete to the tight end, Akins. And he'll only get this to the 47. He needed a few more yards to pick up the first. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. Out comes Christian McCaffrey with the rest of the offense. We're in the second quarter. They've got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what they're seeing so far is the possibility of things loosening up later in the ground game. Through the air first, maybe they have to start respecting that even more as the game goes on, and then there will be running lanes to find later.
Yeah, trying to get him more involved here on this drive, maybe. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. And unable to get downhill there, so he'll take this up to about the 37. Just a gain of two there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. He is going to find Hill here. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A gutsy call. Turns out to be a good one, though. First down on a pickup of 11. And he goes across midfield and down into Houston territory. Play action. It's Darnold. Brought down that time by Christian Kirksey. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Desmond King picks it. And he'll take it all the way up near the 30-yard line. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
That'll be a pickup of 29 yards there. They'll fake the handoff. Now Watson under pressure now. Watson, and down he goes. Lawrence Guy able to get in there and drop him for a loss. Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack. We'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. There's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Out of the gun, Watson. That's going to be complete to his tight end, Akins. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now Watson. A pickup of 11 and a tech. And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. It's hurry-up mode time for the Texans, hustling up to the line. And he finds Danny Amendola. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. On third down, here's Lindsay. And he gets this to the 48, but no further. Well short of the line to gain. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. And he'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 53 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. Gronkowski again, he was the intended target, but it'll be second down. A fake to McCaffrey. Now Darnold. And going deep for Hill. Oh, a contested ball here, and it's going to be caught. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock. He was looking for Gronk that time, and it's second down. They'll fake the handoff. Now Darnold escaping the pressure right. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Tyreek Hill in the final seconds of the first half. And the Patriots will extend their lead here just before halftime. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. And he's got it here for the 2 points, but there is a marker down. So we'll have to see what that's about. That's on Shaq Mason, the guard. And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. They'll try and throw for it. Eluding the pressure right. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Terrence Mitchell.
Well, as most teams do in their two-point attempt, they pass the ball. Instead, it gets intercepted. And remember, if you pick it off, you got a chance to take it all the way back, get 2 points yourself, right?
Yeah, not the case there, but that's why you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside. Oh, a good return up past the 30. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at their 36-yard line. From the gun, here's Watson. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. And now due to apparent time constraints, we fast forward to the beginning of the second half. The Texans down on the scoreboard, but they do get the first crack here as we are back underway in the second half. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Watson. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down. Watson now to throw. And his throw here is incomplete. He's trying to get that to Brevin Jordan, and that'll bring up second down. Here's a give to Lindsey. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. And now we're going to get a stoppage as it looks like, yeah, that's Lindsey still down on the field now. We'll check on his status when we get back. Watson on third down. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Adrian Phillips. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Patriot defense has a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Yeah, the Patriots are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Personally, I'd rather see him kick the extra point there than to go for two, but it almost feels like there's a story within the story here. I mean, this isn't college. You know, size of victory, that matters in those games. Here, all you have to do is win by 1 point. That's all that you need. Instead, they go for it, get two. You got some pretty ticked off folks on the other sideline now.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now it's a quarterback under pressure now, Watson, and down he goes. Lawrence Guy able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Second and 14. Another try after the first down sack. Watson. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
And that is incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's Brian Anger now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Here's Hill on the return. Oh, what a move. A great return there of 22 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And last time out, another touchdown. And I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the fourth quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you because this one's just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats? You and me, trying to get to the airport.
That's
the road
true.
To be fairly
that,
clear
that is
by the
one
time
positive.
We have to leave the booth.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And down inside the 15 he goes. 69 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries. Darnold from the red zone now. Flushed out right. And he's got the open man. It's Allen on the comebacker. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Christian McCaffrey, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Patriots continue to roll.
And while no one on the offensive line will get the 6 points next to their name, they should be credited with this one. Tremendous blocking to get the runner into the end zone.
Yeah, the Patriots are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
But I guess when you're hot, you're hot. I mean, I would just go ahead and take the extra point and move on, but apparently they've got something to prove. Almost feels like something was said this week, and they wanted to make sure that they laid it on them in this game.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
On second down, right back to Lindsey. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. He really hasn't been able to get on track running the football, averaging less than 4 yards a carry.
Yeah, I think that they're going to enjoy the film session because all the defenders are filling their proper gaps on just about every play. And you know what they always say for a defensive coach? When I click off this film, I better see 11 jerseys in the picture going after the ball carrier.
And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. To throw is Watson. And he'll find Akins there, complete. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. And movement here by one of the Texans up front. In comes the flag. Oh, moving from his tight end spot there.
Do you think that perhaps the play call was for him?
Back to throw, Watson. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Third and 2, Watson. It's complete to Chris Conley. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they get 5 there on 3rd and 2. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play. Watson looks to throw again. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Watson. He'll check this down to Johnson. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's 3rd and 10. From the 50, it's Watson. Oh, had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going. So 2 third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with 4th down. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Watch out for Hill on the return. So a good punt, but a solid 12-yard return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. Justin Reed, the safety, made the tackle. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. Room here to run. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. 95 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. Darnold will hand off to McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They get the guard out of Georgia Tech, Shaq Mason. Off of play action, Darnold. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's 2nd down. He was trying to get that back to Allen, but it's going to be 2nd down. Now room for Eckler. And some room to run now. Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line. All told, it's an even 30 and a 1st down. The play fake, and it's Darnold.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Here's second and 10 now from the 35. To throw is Darnold. That's into the hands of Eckler. All the way in. Touchdown, New England. Austin Eckler, his first touchdown on the year. And the Patriots add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a fifth straight victory. Even though they've got this big advantage, Charles, they are not taking their foot off the gas pedal right now.
Well, I think what we're seeing is the result of all their great preparation and great practice time during the week. And even though it seems like this is a great chance to pull people back and maybe, you know, not try and score a few more times, they don't want to do that. I think they're enjoying what they're seeing, the collective effort, and they want to play it all the way out.
Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Give him nine there on the first down completion. Looking to throw again on second down. Watson. His big game continues. 10 catches now and another first down. Looking to throw. Watson. Over the middle and it's incomplete. Chris Conley, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. To the air yet again, Watson. Caught here by Conley. And he's got Rome. And he'll go out of bounds finally at the 7. The thing that hurt on that play, the missed tackle, that allowed the extra yardage.
It's a matchup game in the NFL. You get the guy that you want isolated, have him miss a tackle, and off.
And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late, but he does get in for 6.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give him credit for that. Too little, too late, but no 0. Are you good? You're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And it's looking all the more likely that a fifth straight win is going to be in the cards. They'll try to run some time here with a first and 10. And he'll take this one for about 4 up to the 40. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Here's Darnold. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 49 yards rushing for him now to this point. Here is Eckler. And a penalty flag down as he gets only about a yard. And let's listen in on the call. He was trying to clear the way, the big fullback. Instead, he gets a hold.
And you don't see that very often on running plays from those guys because usually they're the lead blocker. Normally, when he gets caught, it's in a passing situation.
And going deep for Hill. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in. Hill, the intended receiver, once again. Instead of running, Darnold's going to throw this thing. That'll bring up second down. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it. Gronkowski, the intended target. And it's third down. Darnold. Flush to his right.
on the run. He'll let this go deep right side. And that is caught at the 10-yard line.
Even with the big lead.
49ers drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that makes the score 7-0. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Arizona Cardinals offense coming out here for the first time, and you get a peek at Kyler Murray, the dangerous offensive weapon now in his third season in the National Football League. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Here's Murray. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. In our meetings this week, they kind of tipped us off. They wanted to play ultra-aggressive, forcing fumbles. They just did that right there.
They took it to the next level, didn't they? You're exactly right, because everyone talks about being aggressive on defense and tackling well, but they were talking about getting after the football, making sure the ball was stripped out each and every time they lined up someone to get them on the ground.
And the adjustment working early. Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Jackson. And his throw is incomplete. Stephon Diggs, his intended receiver. And it's 3rd down. Jackson now off the bootleg. This is caught. It's Woods. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2. From the 2 now, 2nd and goal. Play action. It's Jackson. He'll buy some time. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Lamar Jackson. His 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Niners are off to a 13-0 first quarter lead. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and that'll make the score 14-0. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this game.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. His first catch, good for 16 and a first. They'll fake it to Connor. Now Murray. And this one caught by Max Williams. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A really nice gain of 25 yards. So from inside Niner territory now, this is 1st and 10 at the 34. First carry for James Connor. And oh, his first carry, he loses the football.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 24-yard line. The Cardinal passing game dialed in now. 1st down. Steps away. Murray with a nice move, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Kyler Murray with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Cardinals have cut it to within a score. And maybe the defense got so caught up in him throwing the football, they forgot he can take off too.
And you often hear about the quarterback being the unaccounted for guy as a runner. Well, even on a passing play, he's unaccounted for as a runner, and he turned it into a nice game.
A very nice run, and it turns in to 6 points. And he returns this to the 22.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And they come into this one riding that nice long win streak. And remember, next weekend is an open week for them. So if they can get the win here, a lot of momentum into that time off.
It certainly is. And if you're wondering if anybody's saying, boy, this is coming at a bad time, we want to keep playing, the answer can be yes, because when teams are on a hot streak, they want to keep going. But what the veterans are telling the young guys in the locker room, an open week is always good, guys. Take it, and let's go with it.
Out to his left. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. They gave him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain. Going deep for Diggs. And that'll be incomplete. Now they took their shot, but the coverage up to the task, and it forces a fourth down. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. To throw is Jackson. Leaping, and he makes the grab. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That one good for 17 yards on fourth. Couldn't ask for much more from your offense there. First down. Give him 9 on the play. And it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. With these run-pass options, we often talk about a good quarterback and running back. Well, having a talented wide receiver helps also.
Yeah, even coming in third in the discussion, sometimes that means he really should be first, because all you want to do is get the ball in their hands and let them make the big plays downfield.
And the Niners are going to have it first and goal as he'll take this down to about the 3. 45 yards on the ground for him so far. Hunt will get down close to the goal line, but not in, as he'll be marked down at the 1. On second down now, it's Hunt. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage, back at the 6. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on 3rd and goal? Call it no gain on the play, so no help there. And now 4th and goal. Such a long drive here. 3 points. That'll be a disappointment, but I don't know if you can go for it here, can you?
Well, you know, the defense was really giving them a lot all the way downfield, and now they've stiffened. Forget
it. Now the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. The fake field goal catches everyone by surprise. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. And a special play there by the special teams. It's one thing to fake it. He ran it in for the score.
I think the special teams coach saw something on film in preparation for this game, told the head coach now's the time. He got the green light, and they worked it to perfection.
Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. Here comes Nelson. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Now he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. That one good for 20 on the catch and run. Murray now on first down. On the move to that, he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. Zach Kerr. Able to collapse the pocket, get to him, and drop him for a loss of a yard. After the sack on first down, Murray, he'll swing that out to Edmonds.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. They'll begin the drive with Hunt. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 12-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Over the middle, complete. That's Watkins. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando. The coach, he'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman both argue the light.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth, and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
They're going on fourth down. It's Jackson. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Fourth down, no problem. 19 yards that time, but now it's first and 10. And Jackson cannot get away, and he'll go down. Chandler Jones able to record his 5th sack of the season. Rolling to his left. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Austin Hooper, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. Now it's Jackson. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee.